Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're going to be working out the area of parallelograms. So let's start with a piece of knowledge I need you familiar with, something we've done previously on Hegarty Maths. Can you remember the formula for the area of a rectangle with base length b and perpendicular height h? Well, hopefully you can remember that it's simply the base multiplied by the perpendicular height. So that's how you get the area of a rectangle, and it's something we're going to need in a second. Let's go on and talk about what parallelograms actually are. Now, a parallelogram is a quadrilateral. That means it's got four sides, quad meaning four, with two pairs of parallel sides. So I'm going to draw a picture of one for you here as follows. So this is an example of a parallelogram. Now, what does two pairs of parallel sides mean? Well, this arrow, this single arrow, and for this line here, and this single arrow for this part here, mean that these two parts are parallel. These two line segments are parallel to each other. These double arrows here means that this line isn't parallel to these ones, it's definitely different, but it's parallel to the other line over here that has two arrows on it. So this shape has four sides, so it's a quadrilateral, and it has two pairs, one pair, two pairs of parallel sides. So this makes it an example of a parallelogram. Now, what we're interested in is what on earth is the area of a parallelogram? Well, we've got the base length of the parallelogram, we've got this slanted length here on the parallelogram, and we've also got a perpendicular height here. This height is perpendicular to the base, and we're trying to work out what the area is. So I wanted to demonstrate to you why the area is as it is. Okay, so let's take this shape here, and what I'm going to do, I'm just going to move it over here or duplicate my shape. So here we go, I've got that parallelogram there and that parallelogram, which have the same area. Now watch what I'm going to do over on this side. Imagine I cut this end bit off here. I drew a straight line down there of length h, cut that down, and I would have created a triangle here. If I move that and I take this and I move it, it exactly fits in this portion over here, because this line and this line are parallel to each other. So if I slot that in, it's going to fit exactly in there. Now watch also what I can do. This base length of this, what now I've formed as a rectangle, is still b, and the height is h, and I know that the area of a rectangle is the base multiplied by the perpendicular height we already talked about in the start. So the area here is the base multiplied by the height. But this green area is the same as this green area. Remember, I dragged this one out from this one, so this, the area of this must also simply be the area of a parallelogram is its base multiplied by its perpendicular height. We don't have to consider this slanted distance at all, we can just ignore it in our calculation. So let's formalize that. For a parallelogram with base length b, perpendicular height from the base h, and this slanted distance s, the area is simply the base multiplied by the perpendicular height, b multiplied by h, and we can ignore the slanted length, it is not necessary in that calculation. So let's work out the area of a few parallelograms. Here's the first one, pause the video and have a go. So we're asked to work out the area of this parallelogram. We have to identify the base length, which is going to be this 12 here, and the perpendicular height, which is this 4 given to us. We're going to ignore the 5 here. So the area is simply 12 multiplied by 4, which is going to equal 48, and the unit is meters squared, and we're done. Next question, pause the video, have a go. So we're asked to work out the area of this shape. We're not told what type of shape it is, but you look at it, you see this arrow and this arrow, so you know it's a pair of parallel sides. You see this double arrow and this double arrow, so you know it's two pairs of parallel sides, and it's a four-sided shape, so you know it's a parallelogram. You know the area of a parallelogram is the base multiplied by the perpendicular height. If that distance there is 2.5, this distance is going to be 2.5. So the base is 2.5 multiplied by the perpendicular height. Now, don't be confused, the 11 is the slanted height. We are also given this 8 here. It's outside our shape, yes, it's not even in the shape, but that is the height perpendicular to the base of this parallelogram. It's 8 high. So it's going to be 2.5 multiplied by 8. And when you do 2.5 multiplied by 8, you get 20, and the unit in this case, because the lengths are in centimeters, the area is centimeters squared. Be super careful not to do 2.5 multiplied by 11. Okay, next question. Pause the video and have a go. So we're asked to work out the shaded area here, so this green area. Now, hopefully you can see we've got a large parallelogram here and we've got a smaller parallelogram in the middle here. In order to work out the green area, hopefully you can see that what I could do is I could take the area of the large parallelogram and I could subtract the area from this small parallelogram. I subtract them and I'm left with the green shaded difference. Okay, so that's what I'm going to try and do to work out the shaded area. So let's say the shaded is going to be the entire area of this massive parallelogram here. Now the area of a parallelogram is the base, which we have is 20, and the perpendicular height. It's not the 15, that's the slanted height. Can we work out the perpendicular? Well, this distance is 2, this distance here is 5, this distance here is 2, so 2 add 5 add 2 is 9. This whole perpendicular height is going to be 9. So the base is 20, let's do 20 multiplied by the 9. That gives us the area of this one here. And we're going to subtract the area of the small parallelogram. Well, that has base 10 and it's got perpendicular height there, you can see it's 5, so 10 multiplied by 5 for the small one, like that. So working this out, 20 multiplied by 9 is 180, subtract 10 multiplied by 5 is 50, 180 subtract 50 is 130, and the unit in this case is going to be meters squared, and we're done. And that's it for this video. Thanks loads for watching.